guys, it's Miss Jones. In your social studies lesson, you're going to be studying the historical development of amusement parks and roller coasters. And now, guys, in your English language arts activity, you're going to give me just a little bit more information about those five roller coasters that you researched. In fact, guys, you're going to be writing a compare and contrast essay. Oh, don't be afraid or moan or groan. It's going to be fun.
Yeah! Woo!
What does it mean to compare and contrast two things? Well, compare refers to the process of identifying the similarities and differences between two things, whereas contrast refers to identifying only the differences between two things. In addition to the research you've already completed for social studies, I'm going to ask you for this language arts activity to dig a little bit deeper to find some more information that maybe somebody doesn't already know about these roller coasters. You've already found out how old these roller coasters are in your social studies lesson. But now I want to see if you could tell me how they've changed over the years. Describe those roller coasters to me. How are the coaster cars decorated? How are the tracks designed? Your science and math lessons will teach you lots of interesting facts about coaster tracks, speed, and the elevation of the dips. So be sure to reference that information in your essay too. You'll also conduct research to find out which coaster is the most popular one in the park. And you can tell me which coaster you prefer and why. Remember, this is a compare and contrast essay. I want you to think critically about the similarities and the differences of these five coasters. If the roller coasters are fun, and they are, you should have a lot to talk about. And next, we're going to talk about the layout of your compare and contrast essay. You'll be writing a 5-paragraph essay, but don't worry, I know it sounds like a lot, but each paragraph only has to be 5 to 7 sentences long. You're going to start with the introduction. You're going to introduce your topic and create a thesis statement. A thesis statement means a summary of the essay. In the next paragraph, you're going to create a topic sentence and introduce the first roller coaster you researched. Use precise details, and as I just said, you'll have plenty of details to choose from. In the paragraph after that, give your topic sentence and then introduce the second roller coaster you researched. Again, use precise details. Next paragraph, compare the two roller coasters. And for your conclusion, you're going to summarize the research that you conducted on both roller coasters and then evaluate why that research is important. Sometimes constructing a good piece of writing can be overwhelming. I know it is. But I'm going to give you a process that even the pros use to help organize their notes. And then write and revise in such a way that it's going to give you the best finished project. The first step in the writing process is pre-writing. It's the stage for brainstorming, to start talking about all those big ideas swirling around in your head and pull them into shape and focus. The next step is drafting. Use your notes from the pre-writing stage, and most importantly, don't worry about making mistakes. This first draft isn't meant to be perfect, it's just a starting point that you will use for the next stage of the writing process. The next stage is revising your draft. Revising is where the magic happens. You add details, you take out off-topic material, you arrange and rearrange and rearrange until you're confident in the way your ideas have taken shape and the language you've used to convey them. The next step is to proofread and fix those errors of your writing. Check for spelling, capitalization, punctuation, and don't forget to fix those grammatical errors. And finally, it's time to publish your paper. If it's written, make sure it's written neatly. And if it's typed, make sure it's free of all errors. If it's a speech, make sure you create note cards for yourself and have all the visual aids you need for your presentation. So what do you think you could learn by comparing the similarities and the differences between these roller coasters? As you'll find out, answering that question requires you to understand the history, the math, and the science of how roller coasters were invented and how they continue to change through the decades. So get set for a wild ride, and don't forget to have some fun too.
To download the free lesson plans to be used with this program, visit us online at wqed.org/SOS. To request a hard copy of the lesson plans, please contact your local school district. Funding for this program is provided by the Pennsylvania Department of Education for Learning at Home.